Jai Shri Gurudev. In this class, we're going to start with the electricity lessons of 10th standard CBSE syllabus. So, now let us know about the definition of the electric current. What is the meaning of electric current? So, electric current is the flow of electrons through a conductor. In a very simple manner, electricity is a flow of electrons through a conductor. The device which causes the flow of electrons through a conductor is called as cell. The device which causes the flow of electrons through a conductor is called cell. Electrons flow from negative terminal to positive terminal. See here, look at here once. Electrons flow from negative terminal to positive terminal. It means electrons flow from negative terminal to positive terminal. But electric current flows from positive terminal to negative terminal. The electricity flows from positive terminal to negative terminal. So this is called conventional current. Here one more time I'm going to explain this one. Look at this one carefully. Electrons flow from negative terminal to the positive terminal. Here negative terminal to positive terminal. The electrons flows from negative terminal to positive terminal. It's the same thing. Electric current flows from positive terminal to negative terminals. So electric current flows from positive terminal to negative terminal. The rate of flow of charges through a conductor or a quantity of charges flowing through a conductor is in unit time. What is meant by electric current is expressed as I. It is a short form of electric current. Instead of writing electric current every time, if you write it as I, it is understood that it is the meaning of I is electric current. It is a short form of electric current. So here, what is there? It is not the short form of the electric current. It is a symbol of electric current. So the rate of flow of charges through a conductor. It means that electricity which is flowing through a conductor. It means it is mentioned as Q. Okay, it is mentioned as Q. Or quantity of charges flowing through a conductor in unit time. Quantity of charges flowing through a conductor. It means Q amount of charges flowing through a conductor in particular time. It means it may be in seconds, it may be in hour, it may be in minute. This one we'll call it as I. The definition, the formula to find out the electric current flowing through a conductor is I is equal to Q by T. Q means quantity of charge, T means time. Next, the SI unit of electric charge is coulomb. The SI unit of electric charge is coulomb. The SI unit of current is ampere. The SI unit of electric charge is what? Coulomb. And the SI unit of current is ampere. 1 ampere is the current flowing through a conductor if 1 coulomb of charge flows through it in 1 second. The SI unit of current is what? Ampere. It's a standard. SI unit means what? International standard units. Okay. 1 ampere of current flowing through a conductor if 1 coulomb of charge flows through it in 1 second. So here they have given it in the fraction method. 1 ampere is equal to 1 coulomb of charges flowing through a wire in 1 second. So electric current is measured by using the device ampere always connected in series in a circuit. Electric current is measured by the device what? Which device they are going to use to measure the electric current? It is ampere. Now let us see a short video here. See here, there are millions and billions of electrons and protons in the subatomic particles. In an object like metals, electrons can move randomly. While in the non-metals, the electrons are fixed or it may be in a stagnant manner. So here, we don't have any free electrons. So if you go to any house, here a negatively charged electrons passes through this bulb in one direction. Charged particles is called as electric current. These wires are made up of copper or aluminium wires. See, why are the electric current in these wires moving in one direction? The charges move in one direction in the wires due to the energy supplied to them by the transformers. Here, the transformer transfers the energy which is moving in the one direction. So here we can see the charge. Here, the charge is getting the energy from the two shells. So, dynamic electricity, flow of electric charges through a conductor in one direction is called as electricity. See here, dynamic electricity. What is the meaning of it? Meaning of it, dynamic electricity, flow of electric charge through conductor in one direction is called as electricity. Okay, here also we can see the examples here. Electricity is flowing in an electron around a circuit. Here, look at here. Electrons are flowing from positive to negative. Electric charge is flowing from positive direction to negative direction. But electricity is flowing from positive direction to negative direction. But electrons are flowing from electric charge is flowing from negative to positive directions. So here, see here, look at here. What about the current? Current is flowing from here. We can see current is flowing from positive to negative direction. That one electron flowing in which direction? Electrons are flowing. Electrons are flowing from negative direction to positive directions. Okay, clear. Next, here electric potential and potential difference. Electric current will flow through a conductor only if there is a difference in the electric potential between the two ends of the conductor. The difference in the electric potential between the two ends of a conductor is called potential difference. It's a very simple one. It means unbalanced charges, or what we call it as in the perfect manner. So electric current will flow through a conductor only if there is a difference in the electric potential between two ends. Difference in the electric potential between the two ends of the conductor. This difference in the electric potential between the two ends of a conductor is called as potential difference. It means here we have a wire. Here we have two transformers. Here one transformer. Here one more transformer. Here if it is having 100 volts of electricity, and here it is having only 50 volts of electricity. So now the current flows from this transformer to this transformer in these directions. Okay, this one we'll call it as potential difference. If the voltage of this transformer and this transformer is same, then the electric charges there, we don't have any potential difference, though. Therefore the electricity does the charged particles does not flow from one transformer to another transformer. So the potential difference is a circuit. In a circuit is provided by a cell or battery. The chemical reactions in a cell produces a potential difference between the two terminals and set of electrons in motions and produce electric current. Now observe this one carefully. The potential difference in a circuit is provided by a cell or battery. The potential difference in a circuit is provided by a cell or a battery. The chemical reactions in the cell produces the potential difference between the two terminals of the cell and the set of electrons in motion and produces electric current. Here, look at this one. Chemical reactions in the battery produces potential difference between the two terminals and sets the electrons in motions and produces electric current. Next, what is meant by potential difference? Potential difference between two points A and B of the conductor is the amount of work done to move a unit charge from A to B. In a simple manner, between two points A and B of a conductor is the amount of work done to move a unit charge from A to B. Amount of work done to move a unit charge from A to B. If you want to move an object from one place to another, there must be a potential difference. So here potential difference is equal to work done divided by charge V. The the symbol of potential difference is V. Work done, the symbol of work done is W, and charge is always Q. It means the potential difference equal to work done divided by charge between two points A and B conductor is amount of work done to move a unit charge from A to B. The SI unit of potential difference is volt. The SI unit of potential difference is volt. The symbol of volt is what? V. The symbol of volt is what? V. 1 volt of potential difference when 1 joule of work done to move a charge of 1 coulomb from one point to other. So 1 volt equal to 1 joule divided by 1 coulomb. 1 volt is equal to 1 joule by 1 coulomb. The potential difference is measured by a voltmeter. Potential difference is measured by a voltmeter. It is always connected in the parallel across the two points between which the potential difference is to be measured. So here, look at this one. Electric charge is measured by using ammeter. So potential difference is measured by using voltmeter. Voltmeter is always connected in parallel, and ammeter is always connected in series.